Hi everyone and welcome back. So in the previous video we were able to set up the basic folder structure for the Next.js SQLize. We created a database module. We actually added all the configurations required inside the core module. You can see the database provider. Here is our database provider, and we were returning the SQLize object from this SQLize config, and we are doing SQLize sync. So whenever you introduce a new entity, it will be able to populate that whenever you do the DB sync. Okay, I mean, whenever you start the applications and if you have written the sqlize.sync, it will look into the entities and compare it against the database. If something new you have added in your entities, it will populate that in the database. So here we have our user and post entities. I mean, same as the type ORM entities, these are the entities we create in the SQLize, same type of annotations, column annotations and all, because we are writing TypeScript. This is the model user, and similarly we have another model which is the post, and this is our database module which is exposing these providers. Okay, so our provider is kind of simple. It's just a use factory functions, and it is returning the SQLize object. And in the add models, you have to add all the models which you need, like user, post, comment, product, cart, all the entities just feed in here. The same thing we do with the type ORM with an SAS, we pass all the entities object in the type ORM.4 feature, if you remember. Okay, now after adding this database module, we can actually think about the additional modules which we are creating. Our app module, this is a root module. And here we will provide our database module. So we have three other modules: user module, auth module, and post module. And I will not be writing much code in this particular sample because we have already created all these kind of auth modules. In the auth module, we use the local strategy fast forward. We use a JWT strategy to actually decode the token and get the user data out of it. So all those things we have done. So let's go to the auth module. What it is doing is it is using this passport module, and it is having this local strategy service and JWT strategy. So if we look into this JWT strategy, it is extracting the token from the bearer. If you remember, if you recall my previous set of videos, we discussed about it, JWT strategy. It actually decodes the token from the authorization header, and it will decode the, we finally get the payload, because we are already implementing the passport strategy. When we validate it, this payload is nothing but the decode version of our JWT token. And we can actually, once we have the ID of user ID of from that token, we can call this and we can check, okay, user exists in our system or not. So before that, we have a local strategy which will help us to validate or authenticate user. And once user is valid, like user email ID and password is valid, we actually can generate a token and send that token to the client. So there is an auth controller we already have. This auth controller is helping us on that. We have a login and we have a simple register controller. Okay. So here you can see we have a does user exist guard. I mean, just a nice example of using a guard, and what it is doing, it is just checking if user exists in our system or not. So, I mean, this is the custom implementation. I really like it. What I have done is, in that particular route, what I want to check if user already exists, then either I will be throwing exception from the service, or you can actually create this custom guard and you can actually check if email already exists, then you can send the user back right away from the route controller. Okay, that email ID already exists, you choose something else. Okay, so this is like can activate. So these are like auth guards. Before entering into the route, this logic will execute, and if you are allowing, if you are not returning any exception, then only it will go forward. So this is our auth controller. And Next.js has these pipes, filters, interceptors, middlewares, nicely written. I mean, they give really a nice structure to your services, your controllers. So here you can see the auth guard. And here I'm using the passport auth guard, which will help me to decode the request object from the payload. It will just check, okay, email ID exists. Then I'm doing the login. it will actually add the user object on the request. So this is the auth guard, and this auth guard is written with a passport local strategy. So here we have the local strategy. What it is doing is, it is just checking where we are. Okay, not in this. Let's close the type definitions and move to our auth controller. So inside the auth controller, we are writing this auth guard. And what this auth guard is doing, it is using this local strategy. For this, in the local strategy, we are validating the user. So this is our local strategy.ts. And here we are validating the username and the password. Okay, so here we are calling auth service.validate user, passing the user username and password. If both are valid, then we are going to return a user, and this user indirectly will become a part of request user. So this is called passport serialization. It does the validations, and in the request object, before your route handles, you have the user object if user is valid. Now what you do is, in the login method, we can just check what we are doing in auth service. If we go and check inside auth service, we have this login method and a create method. Login is just validating. Okay, so this validate user is something which we are calling from the passport, which is going to validate if everything is fine, and we can close this. And then here we have a login. Login is doing nothing but we have the user object, and I can simply generate a token based on the user object I have received. I will return user and token, and this is the user registration. I will do the hash password using bcrypt, and I got the new password. While creating the user, I will pass the new password as a password object, as a user object, and I will create the user. Okay, so this is our auth module, which is just dealing login and registration. Then we have the post module. This is the post entity, user, and the post as a primary key, foreign key relationship. Post belongs to user, and it has a foreign key coming from the user entity. Okay, so whatever the relationship we have discussed in the type ORM, one to one, one to many, many to many, same set of relationship you will see in the SQLize. I already have covered a SQLize in depth in previous playlists, but this can give you the simple example. And here I have the post controller, which is again having the same set of routes. But what we want is, once user is coming inside the post routes, user should always be valid user. User should be holding the valid JWT token. So for that, we have created this auth guard, right? So we already know this auth guard is doing is, it is decoding the token which is coming in the authorization bearer header, and we are decoding, checking user exists in the system. If yes, then only allow user to create post, get post, delete post, update post. Simple CRUD operations we have written. I don't need to talk about it. Here it is simple, get find one. We are passing the ID, and we are using this validation pipe, custom validation pipe, which is validating, okay, ID is of type number. If you are passing something else, it will throw the error. We are doing find one. If not found, we are throwing not found exception. And all these routes are protected with this auth guard JWT, means the logged in user can only access all these APIs. Okay, so this is very simple set of APIs which we have written with the help of SQLize. Now I hope you know how to write a SQLize entities and how to write all these set of services, which is kind of simple. We haven't changed anything with the SQLize. It is the same services. If I talk about simple user service, here I will be using the repositories coming from the SQLize. You can see this is what I'm injecting. In the type ORM also, we were doing the same thing. We are injecting the repository and accessing, and we were getting the access of that repository in the service. Now inside a service method, we can call find one by ID, create, delete, update, and we will be doing this dot repository dot find one, create. Now these queries can be like the structure of what we are writing in the find one, create, find all, can vary based on the type ORM and the SQLize. Okay, so this is what we have. And here also you can see the post service. This is also doing the same thing. Here we are using the post repository instead of user repository. And we are doing post repository dot create, and we are also passing the user ID, right? Because this post belongs to the user. and we are finding all, and you can see post repository dot find all. So we are actually finding or returning the user information also with the post. In the type ORM, this is called relations. Like if you have primary key foreign key relationship, while getting the primary key table, you can actually define the relations, and foreign key data will also be loaded, because by default these are lazy loaded. It will not load the foreign key relationship data, but like include. Similarly, in the type ORM, there is a relations array, and you can specify what all foreign key relationship you wanted to fetch.